Hey everyone, welcome to round one. We've lost the roll and our opponent is mulliganing to six after choosing to play first. This hand is not bad. Unfortunately, Reverent Hunter is our first drop and I don't really want to play it out as a 2-2. So this is something that I prefer to play out later on, perhaps after the centaurs. So we're gonna. Would we like to mulligan a six? No. Depending on the how our draw develops, we might want to play this out just because we can get our beat on, depending on what we're playing against, of course. So it looks like we're playing against white. And we can play the charlatan, I guess. That's going to be just as good as the Reverent Hunter, and it's pretty scary because he does a lot of stuff. He's rare, etc. And a Vaporkin, right on time. So we're going to curve out with Vaporkin into charlatan, into centaurs, and probably feral invocation for one of those. And we've got a 3-3. Boom. So we're just gonna go ahead and play our dude and attack. We play the invocation there, but I think I want to save it for next turn. Make this guy a reasonable attacker. And then play this on five, just because this guy can't really beat the ground right now. Ew, that's disgusting. So unfortunately, we're facing down a phalanx leader. So depending on what we draw this turn, boom, Mylia's presence. That will be good in a few turns. I think we're just going to go ahead and attack with a Vaporkin and then do nothing else. We play this Feral Invocation later. And let's hope that our opponent decides to tap out before attacking. I mean, we can go for the Feral Invocation here, but that plays into a lot of cards, like Battlewise Valor, Divine Verdict. And it just gets a little scary. So now we have to decide whether or not we want to play into something. We can play into a card this turn because next turn we'll have the centaurs, and I would rather have the centaurs around than this guy. So I think it's worth it in this case to do that. So we're just gonna put invocation on him. I mean, this sort of, again, this is playing into stuff, but when your next play is a 3/7, it's seems like it's worth it. We'll have to wait and see what our opponent is going to do. And it looks like a God's willing, so this is turning out about as well as I can hope it would, I suppose. Just because if he's going to play that, then let's see, scry to the bottom. He doesn't have a combat trick, and he doesn't have a play because he has less mana, so that's good for us. So now we just have to play around Savage Surge, which you wouldn't have. You would have played that earlier, so we can attack with everything and then play this Centaurs afterwards. Raw, look at that. Or we can play the Scry Sphinx, but I think I want to just gum up the ground for this turn, so next turn I can. Well, maybe not. We're at 17. Playing this is gonna be fine. That presents a two-turn clock in the air, and that's gonna be good because next turn we can just, depending on what he plays, attack or not attack. And is he bestowing something? Seems like he's bestowing something. Probably Enigma Eidolon on this thing, or maybe this guy. I'd probably bestow it on this. But then he can't attack to gain life, so it's kind of a it's a closer decision. And it looks like he put it on his phalanx leader, so we're just not going to block here, obviously. And now we can attack for potentially a lot. So let's see if he blocks. He's probably not going to block. And then we play the centaurs. Raw! Look at that. Attacking with everything. And then let's go ahead and hold up a null. Now he can target this guy again, and we won't be able to, he can gain some life. But the 4 damage that we end up, that he ends up gaining, we dealt to him last turn by attacking with the charlatan, so it balances out, and we're off to game 2. So, we have some stuff. God's Willing and Enigma Eidolon. We can board in Lightning Strike because Phalanx Leader is sort of annoying, and we don't really have too much to deal with that other than our Bident. So, if we wanted to add Lightning Strike, that would involve putting in Traveler's Amulet and taking out a card. 2 cards, actually. And right now, let's see, being on the draw, I could definitely see taking out one of our 6 drops. And Omen Speaker isn't really that great. We could take out the Charlatan. It's pretty close, actually. Actually, I don't think I'm going to splash another color. It's just going to destabilize our mana base, and he's pretty aggro, so I'm going to go ahead and keep that the way it is. We can board in a Shredding Winds, but we haven't really seen any flyers, although there are a few in white, so we'll just go ahead and...